My name is Irene Bedard, and this is the original site of historic Jamestown, Virginia. Pocahontas was born near here 400 years ago. She was the daughter of the chief of a group of American Indian tribes called the Powhatans. Her real name was Matawaka, but she was always referred to by her nickname, Pocahontas, which meant little mischief. Now the thrilling events of her life have inspired Walt Disney Pictures to create their 33rd animated feature, a tale of passion and prejudice, of love and hope, the story of one of the great American heroines, the story of Pocahontas. Based on the fable and folklore that surrounds her story, Disney's Pocahontas features the voice talents of Mel Gibson as heroic Captain John Smith, David Ogden Stiers as greedy Governor Ratcliffe, Russell Means as Pocahontas' wise and loving father, Chief Powhatan, Academy Award winner Linda Hunt as the mystical Grandmother Willow, and Broadway star Judy Kuhn as the singing voice of Pocahontas. Academy Award-winning composer Alan Menken and Tony Award-winning lyricist Stephen Schwartz have created 7 new songs for the film. I am the voice of Pocahontas in the film, and I'm also your guide for this behind-the-scenes adventure into the making of a Disney animated feature. You are about to meet the artists, animators, and the creative talents who have joined forces to bring one of our country's earliest and most exciting romantic adventures to the screen. Disney animation has always been larger than life. Somehow, Disney artists have always been able to breathe realistic behavior and personality into their animated characters and come up with those great stories that touch our emotions and connect with something deep within us. With Pocahontas, the Disney Studios has broken new ground by basing an animated feature on a real person.
The story is really Pocahontas' story, although we have taken some liberties with it. We knew that she was a bit younger when she met John Smith than we show her in the film. But on the other hand, we felt like the relationship that developed by way of a love story, in addition to the relationship of two people from different civilizations, just added an emotional impact to what finally happens that makes it, I think, a more dramatic telling of the story.
Supervising animator Glenn Keane has been an important part of the Disney family for 20 years. He is the animator who brought the Beast to life in Beauty and the Beast, and he put the bounce in Aladdin's step. But for Disney's Pocahontas, Glenn faced a new set of challenges.
We've never before done a story that based on somebody who actually walked and lived here on Earth. All the other ones have been based on fairy tales and imaginary stories. This one is real.
Pocahontas is the strongest heroine we've ever had in a Disney film. She is open, athletic, vivacious. She's also quite beautiful. She is the kind of person I think that would be everyone's best friend.
Don't you think we're getting a little old for these games?
Disney's Pocahontas is filled with excitement, drama, and romance. The story begins in 1607 with the departure of the Virginia Company from a London port. Their mission? Explore a new land called America under the direction of Governor John Ratcliffe and return with gold and any other riches they can find. They are accompanied by an experienced English soldier, Captain John Smith, whose duty is to provide security for the expedition. But Smith is an adventurer at heart. A man who is eager to explore new lands and face new challenges. This new world that John Smith and his settler friend Thomas were about to discover, the area surrounding the Jamestown settlement in Virginia, was populated by the Powhatan Indians. The Powhatans were deeply spiritual. Their culture was based on a strong appreciation and respect for nature and their environment. It is the clash between the values of these two civilizations, the Powhatans and the English, and the bond of love between the daughter of the Powhatan chief and an English rogue that is at the center of the story of Pocahontas. This monument stands on the original site of Jamestown, now owned and protected by the Association for the Preservation of Virginia Antiquities. This is the spot where 104 English colonists landed in 1607, the year Pocahontas and John Smith first met. Over the years, the story of the beautiful Pocahontas and the dashing Captain Smith has evolved into an epic romantic legend, a blend of historical fact and romanticized fantasy. But there's a great deal of disagreement among many historians about the true details of this event. Though the film was inspired by the folklore and fables surrounding the legend of Pocahontas, Disney filmmakers knew that the character of Pocahontas was at the heart of the story. They realized somehow they would have to get to know her if they were going to capture her spirit. This is the Susan Constant at Jamestown Settlement in Virginia, a living history museum located next to the site of the original Jamestown. This Susan Constant is a full-scale replica of one of the three ships that brought Captain John Smith and the English colonists to Virginia. In 1607, the English believed that the New World was a place to find fortune and glory. But what did Pocahontas think when she first saw the billowing sails of the Susan Constant? That was one of the first questions the Disney filmmakers asked when they began work on the film. How would Pocahontas react to the English settlers? What would she think? What would she feel? What kind of person was Pocahontas? Before they could tell her story, they would have to get to know her.
We were trying to really find Pocahontas's tone. We knew we wanted her to be a very spiritual person, somebody who has a connection with nature all the time and whose thoughts run deeper than might seem at surface. But she also always had a playful side, a mischievous side, that we also wanted to capitalize upon for the entertainment value of that. So it took the fine balance to find who Pocahontas was.
The Disney creative team knew right away that the legend of Pocahontas had all of the ingredients of a great film. They began to develop the script and storyline by conducting intensive research into Pocahontas' story. At the same time, art director Mike Giamo had to figure out how the film should look.
We feel that we've really pushed a lot of boundaries in this film in terms of design and color. An art director is responsible in an animated film for coordinating all the visual elements in a movie. So it deals with the grand scale and the small in terms of environment. But I also deal with all the color palettes in the film, costuming of characters, and coordinating the design of the characters with the design of the environment to create a look that's total and whole and unified.
To ensure that the feeling and tone of Pocahontas accurately reflected the spirit of the Native Americans depicted in the film, the filmmakers consulted with a variety of technical experts, historians, and Native American leaders. Actor Russell Means has been active in Native American issues for years. The filmmakers cast Russell in the role of Chief Powhatan, the leader of his tribe and the father of Pocahontas. They also consulted with him to ensure that they were accurate in the way the film depicted early Native Americans.
I mentioned that all the dwellings face east, so they all face in one direction. So if you'll notice in the script that the dwellings all do face one direction, they're not all a hodgepodge. Address one another by relationships rather than by name. That's specifically true with Powhatan and his interaction with his daughter.
My daughter.
Wingapo, father.
Seeing you gives me great joy.
Those are just some of the little things that the producer and directors listen to. So I'm very pleased with this and very proud is the optimum word that I want to use. I'm very proud to be associated with it. I just can't get over the fact that the truth is being told here. When I read the script, I was impressed with the beginning of the film. In fact, I'm overwhelmed by it. I think this is the single most finest work done on American Indians by Hollywood ever.
Something's about to happen, something exciting.
This is the first Disney film based on a historical event where we actually have, you know, people, you know, buried in graves somewhere who did these things that we are now dramatizing.
Our movie is based not just on on what is known, but also on the folklore and legend that surround Pocahontas. There's not a lot of first-hand material that is available. In fact, the famous incident in the movie of Pocahontas saving John Smith's life, there's controversy among historians whether or not it really happened. So we felt that since historians among themselves can't agree, that we, you know, we had a certain amount of license to use what is known from the folklore to create this story.
The Disney animators knew that somehow they had to capture the personality and character of Pocahontas. Animator Glenn Keane traveled to Virginia to absorb the ambiance of the actual location of the story.
Well, at the early stage, you have to find something that's going to inspire you. In the case of Pocahontas, I thought, I need to go to Jamestown. I need to go to Jamestown to experience whatever might happen. So I went down there, and I remember walking around out in the woods, picturing, maybe it was right under these trees here that John Smith was waiting for Pocahontas.
The more they learned, the more Pocahontas' story captivated the imaginations of the Disney filmmakers. But to make the characters completely believable, they had to find the right actors to provide the characters' voices. While the animators could capture the image of the characters, the actors had to capture their spirit. If you walk the footsteps of a stranger, you'll learn things you never knew you never knew. That's one of lyricist Stephen Schwartz's favorite lines from The Colors of the Wind, one of the new songs written by him and composer Alan Menken for the film Pocahontas. That line is really at the heart of the film because it means that if you try to see things from someone else's point of view, you will gain a great wisdom and a deep understanding of others. When actors are asked to perform a character voice in a Disney animated film, they're not being asked to merely read words. They are being asked to totally focus their acting talents on bringing their particular character to life. And when an actor really gets under the skin of his character, he may learn things he never knew he never knew.
It's a good deal more complicated than I would have imagined. It's all just a process of, like, experimentation and so on. They have a pretty clear idea of what they want when they come in, and they communicate that to me as an actor as best they could. It's like cutting off some of your senses and just using one aspect of yourself, and you have to use a lot more imagination. There's a world of possibilities there in animation that don't exist elsewhere. And they're all at someone's fingertips.
Flit, he's back. Come on, Miko.
I loved my role as the speaking voice of Pocahontas. I think the story of Pocahontas is one of the most beautiful love stories ever told.
She brought a depth to the performance of Pocahontas that is different than, say, with Ariel or Jasmine or Belle. Pocahontas is more of a woman instead of a teenager. And there's got to be sincerity and nobility in the way she speaks.
This is how we say hello. Wingapo.
Like everything else in this picture, less is more. And Irene gave a performance that was very controlled and confident. It fit perfectly with Pocahontas.
Another voice fit perfectly with Pocahontas as well, the beautiful singing voice of Judy Kuhn.
I guess I didn't realize what incredibly complicated and painstaking process it is and how many layers there are as the thing evolves. You know, I guess maybe I thought I'd just go into the studio and sing a song, and that would be the end of that. But it's more complicated and involved than that. And it's a much bigger challenge than that.
Actor David Ogden Stiers was challenged to play two parts.
Well, David is just a great actor. I mean, he is, he not only plays Ratcliffe, he also plays his manservant, Wiggins. So we have recording sessions where he played both parts opposite himself.
I made it myself.
Take that silly.
Just, it's all focus and concentration. It was a little while before someone rather well placed at Disney did not know the other actor's voice, knew that I was doing Ratcliffe, but wasn't sure who was playing Wiggins, and that's a slice of heaven.
When I see you wear that necklace, you look just like your mother.
I don't think there's anybody on the planet who could have given Powhatan's voice the warmth, the depth, and the scope than Russell Means. When we had him in to read a couple of lines for us, we were all blown away by the depth that he brought.
Whenever the wind moves through the trees, I feel her presence.
I looked at Powhatan and at my own ancestors in trying to capture his spirit. And I was able to identify with Powhatan and become part of him. It was actually very easy because he's my role model.
Hello, John Smith.
Pocahontas, that tree is talking to me.
Then you should talk back.
Casting the human Don't characters was challenging enough, but how do you find someone to play a 400-year-old tree? Well, you find an Academy Award-winning actress named Linda Hunt.
We wanted a tree that sounded 400 years old, but with a great deal of liveliness. So she managed to do both of those things and give Grandmother Willow a humorous edge as well as being a spiritual guide for Pocahontas.
He has a good soul, and he's handsome too.
Oh, I like her.
She knew exactly how to read each line. She had very strong opinions on it, and she was always dead on. She's just a tremendous actress.
They put hidden video cameras around the place and they catch you reading. And every now and then, you catch, in the cartoon itself, you catch that they've stolen an expression off your face. You can see what they've done. It's very clever, very clever.
Watching a Disney animated film is like watching a magic trick. Audiences can get so absorbed in the movie that they actually begin to feel what the characters are feeling. Bringing a Disney animated feature to life takes a lot of talent and hard work. But there are a few secrets that we are about to discover. In the film, Pocahontas senses she's on the verge of a great personal discovery. She believes that something is waiting for her, just around the river bend. Making a Disney animated feature is a journey filled with discovery for everyone. The artists, animators, and all the technicians who work behind the scenes. Each new film has its own unique set of challenges that must be overcome before the final product can be put before the public. There is no instruction manual on how to do it. Each project is a new experience. So, what is the secret? How do the Disney artists keep making such good movies?
And I think part of the magic of Disney animation is the fact that one goes through an evolutionary process of it doesn't work, 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 and finally it works, with changing it over and over again. I think the secret is of being open to change. Never get married to your own ideas.
I can't draw without really feeling it and believing it. Eric Larson, one of the old timers in animation, kept saying to me, Glenn, you've got to animate with sincerity. Okay, animate with sincerity. I put my pencil down the paper and what does that mean? Do you press harder on the pencil? Do you grit your teeth more? I mean, what is sincerity? And as I listened to these guys talk about Pinocchio and Snow White and I found out that they weren't referring to cartoon characters. These were real people that they knew. They just happened to be drawings. When I first started, I thought animation was about a lot of moving drawings. And I find that that's not what it's about. It's not about moving drawings. It's about drawings that move people.
Supervising animator John Pomeroy is a history buff who has done extensive reading about early America, including the actual autobiographical writings and journals of the real Captain John Smith.
It's the amount of substance that the animator will craft into the character. Sometimes it's obvious and sometimes it's hidden. But it radiates a certain spirit or life force that convinces the viewer that this two-dimensional artwork is alive, living, and breathing. Consequently, we get the audience to bite off on it, and we engage in that wonderful, willing suspension of disbelief.
The supervising animator for Governor Ratcliffe found a way to create personality from geometry.
Well, largely he's greedy and corrupt, and he sort of represents an effete aristocracy. So we translate those character traits into geometrical shapes. That's basically how it arrives. In the earlier versions of Ratcliffe, he was much more pear-shaped. As we realized he was turning into more of a nasty villain in development, we raised his center of gravity to his chest, so he seems more pompous and nasty and arrogant and physically menacing.
We will eliminate these savages once and for all.
You like it, eh?
Mako supervising animator Nick Ranieri drew his inspiration from himself.
I think you just basically put yourself into that position. It sounds cliche, but you actually have to become the character. And Pocahontas says something to you, how would you react without actually saying something? You get upset, considering you think of your personality as I'm always hungry and she says this to me, or John Smith doesn't have any more biscuits and I'm like, you know, I'm really upset. I just sort of try to get it from within and use whatever acting skills I have.
Dave Brooksma studied films on hummingbirds to come up with all the right moves for Flit.
I studied hummingbirds to determine how they moved and what made a hummingbird unique in its movement. And then I tried to adapt a personality to fit that, a nervous staccato movement. And I did a several second test of Flit on a twig where he's looking around and reacting to things off stage. And when many of the lead people at the studio saw that, they realized that this character could come alive. And on the strength of that test, he was added to the story.
Some animators are inspired by the performance of the actor playing the part of the character they're drawing. Some animators look to other classic Disney films for inspiration, while others research and experiment and think about the character they're working on for a very long time. But veteran Disney animator Ruben Aquino, supervising animator of Powhatan, has learned to trust magic.
It feels great, especially when the audience reacts the way you hoped they would react. If they laugh at the right places and sigh at the right places or go cheering at the right places, it's a great feeling. It's like you created magic, you know, although you hear that word all the time. It's still a word we use all the time when we're talking about what we do, because we still have that pixie dust, you know.
Early Native Americans used drums to communicate. Their rhythms carried messages and were full of meaning. In Pocahontas, there are 7 new songs from Academy Award-winning composer Alan Menken and Tony Award-winning lyricist Stephen Schwartz. These songs help communicate what the characters are thinking and feeling. They're songs that carry messages and are full of meaning.
Ever since The Little Mermaid, Alan Menken has been giving his own kind of special meaning to Disney animated films through his Academy Award-winning musical scores. The successful partnership with the Walt Disney Studios has continued through Beauty and the Beast, Aladdin, and now Pocahontas. He knows how important it is to be brought into each new project from the start.
You really want to tell the story through song and conceive a score that creates a world, that opens up a whole world. And so you can't do that kind of thing just overlaid over another story. You need to be right there from the very beginning.
We'll look through the whole story of the show and say, okay, well, I think we'll do a song there, and this should probably be a song for the villain here, and so on. And it's however many songs the piece seems to need.
There's not much difference between writing animated films and the stage. You basically still have to tell a very similar kind of story.
Just around the river bend. Just around.
When Pocahontas realizes that she's different, that she wants something more, that's a musicalization moment. And Just Around the River Bend is the song that she sings there.
Just Around the River Bend.
Another memorable Menken-Schwartz song from Pocahontas is a beautiful love ballad, If I Never Knew You, performed by Shanice Wilson and John Cicada.
I'd have lived my whole life I never knew.
I've been a big, big fan of all the animated films that Disney has done in the last few years. I think they're magical. They really are.
Lost
first song we wrote was Colors of the Wind. It's a very good song. You can feel those things.
Have you ever heard the wolf cry to the blue corn moon? Or ask the grinning bobcat why he grinned? Can you sing with all the voices of the mountain? Can you paint with all the colors of the wind? Can you paint with all the colors of the wind?
It's a song with, I think, both a very strong musical identity and a strong thematic identity. It galvanized Pocahontas. It lifted everything. There's a certain way when something works and something functions and really helps the story in a really powerful way, it elevates that work. And I just, the colors obviously felt like an important song from an important project.
I guess I'm really proud of Colors of the Wind. I like it when I'm able to find a way to say something in an unexpected but very simple way.
Can own the earth, and still all you'll own is earth until you can paint with all the colors of the wind.
Sometimes, during the process of creative discovery, a few things might just happen. The animators call them creative accidents, but unfortunately they are rare. Typically, the magic of Disney animation is the result of hard effort, tireless experimentation, and a commitment to continually push the work forward to achieve the best result possible. Each Disney animator has their own unique way of solving creative problems. But regardless of the method they choose to reach their goal, all of the creative people we've met here really enjoy what they're doing. And that's the greatest secret of all, because making Disney's Pocahontas was truly a labor of love. I'm Irene Bedard, and thank you for watching.